Hello everyone, this is Stiofan from GeoDirectory. Today we're going to go over a few different ways you can use Elementor to add a contact form to your GD listings. In our basic GD listing just now, we don't have any sort of contact form. We have our email button and some contact information, but no actual form. So we're going to show you how to do that today. First thing to do is go down to Templates and Popup. And we'll add a new popup and we'll call it GD contact form. Now you'll notice this is our own template that we've added in, just a quick basic contact form. Now we'll insert that. You can do one from scratch. This just basically adds in the template quickly. And you can still edit any of the sort of content that you want to edit. It is basically just a Elementor Pro form widget. The only difference being the after submit action, we have our own GD email listing, whereas usually you'd have it just as email. Now the settings are almost identical to the Elementor form settings, except the two will take the email address from the listing rather than you entering a specific email address. And the message, the subject, and everything else can be edited as normal. So we'll just go ahead and publish this. As it's a contact form, we're not going to add any conditions. We're going to add our own triggers. So we'll just save and close. Let's exit to the dashboard. Let's go to Theme Builder, GD Single, and we'll edit our Places template. Now we have a few buttons here for Featured and Verified. These are just standard Elementor buttons. We'll show you how to open that contact form just with an Elementor button. So let's go grab a button. Throw it in here. Let's make it align correctly first, positioning in line. There we go. Okay, we're going to call this a contact form. Envelope. Okay, so we've got the button there. Now we need to make it open the actual pop-up. So if we go to the link element and dynamic tags, you can just go down to actions, pop-up, you click the wrench icon, or you can click anywhere over the title and start typing the name of the form that we created. And if we update that, and then go to the front end and refresh, we have our contact form button. Now this listing isn't featured or verified, so the other buttons disappear. So there we have our basic contact form, which will email the email address of the listing. Now, if, for example, the listing has not entered the email address and there is no email, we don't want to show this contact form. So the way we would do that is, again, click on the button, go to Advanced, go to CSS Classes. So we go to the Dynamic Tags. And then we've got this CSS Hide Condition for GeoDirectory. And then we want to see if we have an email that is empty, then it'll be hidden. So we can do that and update. Now this listing does have an email address, so it will show, but now we know that if the listing doesn't have an email address, then it won't show. Now there's other ways, other things you could do to be able to show the contact form differently, which we'll go over now. Well, first we'll show you how to, so this is the Elementor social icons widget. So we can open the contact form with one of the social icons. So we have that set to pop up. Set that open contact form and update. Refresh. Now when we click on this contact email button will automatically open up the widget that we just created. Now, the issue with the standard Elementor social icons is this will open up the contact form no matter if there is an email address present or not. So there is a way around that, which we'll go over at the end. But first, I'll just show you another way we can add a contact form. Now, the contact form is just the Elementor Pro form widget. Form, we could drag that anywhere, drag it over to the sidebar. Let's just quickly give it a background, a white background. Oops. There we go. I will give it some quick padding. Okay, so when you first add a contact form, it automatically adds the email action. So we don't want that. We want to get rid of the email action and add in the GD email listing action, which is all set up to go. So all you have to do is select it and click update. And now when we go to the front end, we automatically have a contact form. Now, I said I'd go over how we can show this differently depending on whether it has an email address present or not. So let's quickly just go over that. We'll exit to the dashboard. And we will go to Popups, Edit with Elementor. So let's add in a text editor, let's add in a title. Now we have a message, this listing has not added an email. Now we only want to show this in certain conditions. So again, we can go to the advanced CSS classes, go down to the hide conditions. And again, we'll look for email. And if the email address is empty, then we want this to show. So this is a hide condition, so we want to say if it's not empty, then we want it to hide. So that's the way to do it for that. And then we can do the opposite for the other things on the page. So let's go for the title, hide condition, email. If it's empty, then we want it to hide, because we're just going to show that other message. And again, we can do it with the contact form. CSS classes, hide condition, email, if empty, hide. And then we'll update that. Save and close. If we open up the contact form, we still see that it has the contact form. So let's remove the email address so we can see it in action. Let's go to places, edit. Let's find the email address. Now, once we go back and refresh, we'll see this button will disappear. And if we click the email icon, we'll say this listing has not added an email. You can add any message you want there, but it's just one of the limitations with, if you want to use the pop-up with the social icons thing, you'll have to add a wee separate message there. And I think that concludes emails and contact forms for GeoDirectory and Elementor. Thank you.